Fenrir Greyback was an evil werewolf, and he was one of the first werewolves to join the army of Lord Voldemort. He was in the inner circle of Lord Voldemort and was even made a Death Eater. He was a very strong werewolf, and every werewolf in the European region feared him, and this was the reason he was made the leader of the European werewolves. And this is the life of Fenrir Greyback. Fenrir Greyback was presumably born before 1945, and it is unknown from which year he went to Hogwarts and when he received his Hogwarts letter, but he was sorted into Slytherin House. He was inflicted by an unknown werewolf when he was a young child and was made a werewolf after that. He then made it a mission to bite each and every child in the world and make them a werewolf like him as well. He was described as Remus Lupin as one of the most savage werewolves alive today. He was the werewolf that bit Remus Lupin and made Remus also a werewolf. He attacked Remus because Remus's father, Liar Lupin, said that the werewolves deserved nothing else but death. And he took this revenge and attacked Remus Lupin and made him a werewolf, and was very cruel to him when Lupin used to transform into werewolf and join the werewolf army. It is unknown from which year forth he went to Hogwarts, but he went to Hogwarts when Professor Dumbledore was newly appointed as the headmaster of Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry. He was neither a top student, neither a good student. He was a middle student, but he succeeded in defense against the dark arts and charms. He had very good dueling skills as well. It is unknown whether he was made a prefect or a head boy during his years at Hogwarts. After passing from Hogwarts, he didn't get a job anywhere and used to wander here and there, and soon became a snatcher and was in a very famous group of snatchers. When Lord Voldemort started to rise in his power, he joined Lord Voldemort's army in exchange for as many kids as much he wanted to bite. Lord Voldemort knew that Fenrir wasn't going to be loyal to him, as Fenrir had thought that after biting the student and all the children, he would make a werewolf army and rule the world. But his dreams weren't succeeded, as Lord Voldemort knew what was going in his heart and stopped him and didn't allow him many children. Even he didn't allow him a single child during the First Wizarding War. During battles, he was just allowed to kill them and go forth, but he wasn't allowed to bite them. After the First Wizarding War ended at the downfall of Lord Voldemort by little Harry Potter, the werewolves that were allied with Lord Voldemort, including Fenrir Greyback, fled, and they ran for their lives. They stayed hidden until Lord Voldemort rose back to power in 1995 at the end of the Triwizard Tournament held at Hogwarts, where Cedric Diggory was killed and Voldemort came back to power. After that, he started to collect his army back, and Fenrir Greyback again allied himself with Lord Voldemort, this time in hope of getting children to eat and pray. Fenrir also fought in the Battle of the Astronomy Tower with the Death Eaters. He attacked many Order members and Orders. He left a very deep scar on the face of Bill Weasley and attacked Neville as well. He was on the roof when Lord Severus Snape killed Dumbledore. He then fled with them and stayed hidden with Lord Voldemort, and started to continue his job as a snatcher when Lord Voldemort took over the Ministry of Magic. He and his group found Harry, Hermione and Ron in a forest and brought them to Malfoy Manor. where the children were tested and tortured. There was promised that he would be given Hermione to eat, but the trio escaped along with Mr. Ollivander, Luna, Griffook, and Dean Thomas. And Fenrir again ran with the Snatchers and continued his job. Fenrir also fought in the Battle of Hogwarts and almost killed Lavender Brown, but was stunned by a stunning spell by Hermione. But one spell was not enough for him. Then he stood up, a divination ball was thrown on his head by Professor Trelawney, which was the reason he fainted and did not continue to participate in the battle for a very long time. When both the armies of Lord Voldemort as well as of Hogwarts stopped the battle for the break, he returned to the Forbidden Forest and stayed there until the battle resumed. And he fought Ron Weasley and Neville Longbottom in the Great Hall, but was overpowered by the two and was stunned and thrown in a corner in the room. It is likely that after the Battle of Hogwarts ended, he was either killed or imprisoned as life imprisonment for the crimes he did and for the support he gave to Lord Voldemort. He was a very evil werewolf and didn't care to take life. He had taken his mission to make every child on Earth a werewolf, but was very unsuccessful in this. A big role in of his evilness was played by Lionel Lupin, who stated that werewolves deserve death. When Lyle said that, Fenrir got very angry and chose a mission and started a mission to bite every child and make them a werewolf. And he started and think that he should start his mission by attacking Remus Lupin, son of Lyle Lupin. And he did it, and then he soon became a savage werewolf. He had a very strange liking for human flesh and blood, and would even drink human blood and eat human flesh when he was not a werewolf, meaning when he was in his human form. He was very evil and was very devout and loyal to Death Eaters, to Snatchers, to the Dark Side, and especially Lord Voldemort. And that is all for the life of Fenrir Greyback, and I really hope you have enjoyed this video. And if you have enjoyed it, then don't forget to hit the like button, and you may also leave your comments below in the comment section. I would love to read your comments, whether they are an appreciation, suggestions or criticisms. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed it yet, and you can also follow me on Instagram justme268. And some of my other videos also might be appearing on the left and right hand side of the screen. Please do watch them, like them, share them, and leave your comments below them as well. And don't forget to watch the beautiful Christian songs and their tutorials by John Thapa and his channel. Thank you very much, guys, for watching this video once again.